We actually scrape tens of thousands of leads from Apollo as it's really one of our primary sources, and we do it at a fraction of the cost as most Apollo subscribers. Hey, business owners. Today, I'm gonna be showing you the two ways that we scrape leads from Apollo. I'm gonna be showing you how to do it the way that we do it as a lead gen agency. For those of you who don't know who I am, my name is Garik Tate, and I help B2B businesses get new clients with a mixture of AI software development and cold email outreach. Let's dive in. All right, so what you're seeing here is a real search that we use at the beginning of our funnel. So basically the way that we do cold email outreach, it all starts off with how we scrape a lead list. And for us, we use a mixture of Sales Navigator from LinkedIn, Apollo, and Google Maps. But our go-to when we're first starting our campaign is almost always typically Apollo. And that's because their search feature is really useful. So we're gonna be publishing videos down the road about how we then enrich these leads and message these leads and write cold email for these leads. But this is a video just first about how we scrape the leads. And first, this is an example of a real campaign that we actually run. So this is a campaign we're doing for investment bankers and business brokers. So this is targeting primarily owners of businesses. So these are people who have owned their particular business for 10 plus years, whose total years of experience are 35 plus. So typically, if people start to work in their 18s or early 20s, then this would be people guaranteeing they're about 55, basically just around pre-boomers as a minimum. And so therefore, are probably thinking about retirement and their legacy. We're targeting only people in the United States, and we're making sure that the businesses are at least somewhat big. These are certain keywords that we are excluding, as these are industries where it's actually harder to sell a business, so we're just not bothering. And those are all the primary filters for this. A pretty powerful search, but very, very simple. Also on this, you'll notice that we have constructed this table to bring up the most relevant details. We're going to be talking more about why that matters in a second, but let's take a step back. So you can see this search is about 47,000 results. So how much would it cost to actually extract 47,000 results from Apollo? In order to extract 47,000 on a basic plan, which you can see here, we have a special deal with Apollo, so we get a little bit cheaper. But for most people, it costs about $60, which gives you basically 1,000 free export credits. This is how much it costs if you want to programmatically extract the leads, which for us as an automation first agency is really important. We want to do this automatically. We don't want to be paying a VA to copy and paste between tables. You know, 1,000 not going to be enough. If we want to do 45,000, it's going to cost maybe something like $2,000, which could be worth it, but that's definitely going to be a big upfront investment if you're going to be running a campaign. And so the question is, how can you do this for significantly cheaper? So there are two ways I'm going to be showing you about how we scrape leads from Apollo. The first is we use the front end of Apollo with some Chrome extensions, which I'm going to be walking you through. The second one is a little more programmatic, and it's using a third-party tool that lets you scrape the leads by a significant discount. So let's dive into the first one, which is the one that we actually use most of the time. It's a little bit easier, and it also takes significantly less time, though there is a little bit of a price tag to it, significantly less than $2,000. So this right here is a tool that we use. It's called EnrichIQ.com. The way it works is pretty straightforward. There's a few other tools out there. For instance, we also have Export List right here. Export List is another big name out there in the market, but frankly, I've tested both. Export List used to have fewer bugs, but recently EnrichIQ has cleaned up a lot of their system, and I really can just embrace EnrichIQ a lot more. I'm not associated with either one of these businesses, but this is just my own personal testing. Though if you are getting buggy results, which I'm going to be telling you about how to be checking for that, then you might also want to check out Export List to try it out. But EnrichIQ is generally cheaper. Also, I just find their UI and their process a little bit better. So the way it works is you just enter in your name, your email address, and then you paste in the Apollo link. So remember back here when I have all my filters and I bring up 47,000 results, I can just cut this and paste it back into here. Say the number of leads I want, which I just do the same number as the results. So let's say 48,000, because that's, you know, rounding up. Sometimes, you know, because this is pretty cheap, sometimes I'll just round up in case there was actually more leads from Apollo that weren't there. Call it whatever I need to call the campaign. In this case, investment banking, let's say. And then this one, I think that they have a special deal for Indian clients. Click submit, and then you enter your credit card information through Stripe. So you're gonna be sent an email and then fill out a payment page like this. And from there, they then just start processing on the back end. All right, so here are the results. And you can see here is all the information provided. I've just now blacked out the email for obvious reasons. But you can see here, you get all the relevant information. And the thing I really like about this is that it is filled out in a Google Sheet. And our system, just really like to use Google Sheets. We use it for most of our processing of data. And you get their LinkedIn URL, their company LinkedIn URL. You get their website if you have that. You get their corporate phone number, their emails, and all the information that we could possibly need for the next step. Overall, I do like EnrichIQ's information that they present a little bit more for a couple of reasons. One is that when they give you the Google Sheet, it just is there permanently. With export lists, they delete the data after like 24 hours. So you have to make sure that you're on top of your email just in case it goes away, which can be painful. It also just shares more information on the client, which you're not going to need most of this stuff. Most of the stuff you can just right click delete, but some of this stuff is actually pretty helpful, such as if you're using the technologies, the SEO descriptions, or the location for your AI copywriting. So that's something we can talk about more in a future video, but just knowing that this data is useful is probably helpful. That's how we actually scrape leads. But now let me show you another way that is probably going to be even cheaper. The other way you can scrape the results is somewhat more manual, but something you can get a personal assistant or a virtual assistant to help you out with. And the way that you're going to be doing this efficiently is using a Chrome extension. So there's a lot of scraper Chrome extensions out there on the market. Personally, my favorite, once again, not affiliated with this in any way, is Easy Scraper. But the most popular out there on the market that's a lot more trusted and has a little bit of a bigger brand behind it is a tool called Instant Data Scraper. Now, it's important to remember with both of these tools that they are free tools, which means that if you are not the customer, then you're probably the product. And so for me, the way that I do it is I actually just have these Chrome extensions turned off when I'm not using them. But when I need them, they are really, really powerful. How do we use them in this case? First of all, what they are going to do, let me just show you how they actually work. So the way it works is it scrapes all the results from the table on the screen, and that's about it. And then you can have it scrape by crawling the next few pages. So here you click on locate next button and then just highlight this just so. And once that's done, go back, click start crawling. And what's going to do is it's going to automatically press the next button, load that page, scrape those results, so on and so forth. And you can see here it's now scraped the next batch, added that in. If we give it a second, oh, table not found. Looks like IDS is not working. Let's try Easy Scraper. All right, future Garik here. And I can verify that actually Easy Scraper looks like it is a better tool, at least on my setup. That's why actually I do have both tools, because sometimes different ones are better at different websites. And it looks like here, the exact same process. You have the action, click link to navigate to next page, select the button, start scraping. It's going to scrape it. And then when it gets to the end of the page, you can see here it scraped 25 results. Loads up the next page, goes to page 4, and starts scraping those results next. And it really is just that easy. Now, there's an important point here, which is that you have not added their emails, because in order to access their emails, you need to access it by pressing this button. So how do you do this in mass? Well, the really simple way that we do it is like this. First of all, you have to save this list. And when you save the list, you're also expending Apollo's email credits to get the list. But weren't we just saying that Apollo email credits are going to cost you $2,000 to get enough? No, actually, because those were export credits. That's in order to export it via their API. But in order to reveal it via its user interface are significantly cheaper. And so in fact, you can set up just a series of very low level Apollo accounts that are fairly cheap, just the minimal level. And you'll get, it used to be 10,000. It might change in the future to 5,000. But as of the recording of this video, it was 10,000 last I checked. You'll get 10,000 for the minimal price of the Apollo product, which is completely different economics. So you can just create multiple of those accounts and then use the Chrome extension to scrape them. But how do you actually go about doing it? How do you save the leads and then get access to emails? Well, the way you go about doing it is you just click here, the checkbox to get all of them. You select all, oh, but here it says only 10,000. So you can only save them at batches of 10,000. In fact, you might want to select even smaller numbers depending on how many email credits that you have. You can see here your email credits usage. You can see here I still have 10,000 emails I can extract this month. You can see I haven't used up any because, well, honestly, we use EnrichIQ instead. But this means I can scrape up to 10,000 results. So I could probably select all here, the 10,000, and scrape all 10,000. But you can see, even if I scrape 10,000, that's still going to be less results than the total 46,000 saved. So how do you go about doing this? Well, the simple answer is that you're going to save them in batches. And each batch that you save should be a batch that you exclude in the next saving. Here, let me show you what I mean. So after you save a list, which I'm going to be showing you how to do in a second, you're going to be saving that as a separate list, which then underneath the list here, people, hide advanced settings, exclude. You can exclude that list to then make a smaller chunk. So here you can see I have 4,000 because I've excluded the previous batches that I did. So now let's try with this. select all, apply, and then from here, we're going to go to save. And let's just go with everything, just get everything at the same time. Include catch-all emails, all good for us, because we're going to revalidate the emails down the process. Subscribe if you want to see the next video in the series. Click next, and then here you're going to name it. So here for this particular campaign, I've just been numbering them. So we're going to call it Arthur 6. Save. And you can see here the prospects are being added. Let's give it a second and come back to this. All right, it looks like it's saved up enough of them, 3,800, not all of them yet, but it will save up the rest, probably even as we're filming this. All right, it looks like enough of the leads have loaded up. You can see here we have about 3,800 results. Probably the rest are going to still be loading as we continue filming this. So what you're going to do is you're going to move to saved, and then once it's moved to saved, you can now see that you do actually have the email. So if you want to only extract those that you just now scraped, what you can do, the easiest way to do it consistently is just remove the list from before. You can actually remove all the filters at this point, it doesn't matter, but I'll leave on the rest of the filters. And you're gonna open the list. And then you're just going to include that list, include this time rather than exclude, include that list that you just now did. So you've basically just taken a bite out of the bigger 47,000, you're just taking a single bite out of the result. And now you can scrape this on Easy Scraper just the way that I showed before. So here I could close this, open it up again. Select the next button, click start scraping, and you can see here, it just starts scraping the results, just like that. And when it finishes, I'm just gonna click stop scraping now, I can just copy the CSV and I'm off to the races. And once it finishes, you can just click on copy and it'll copy the results to your clipboard or you can download as a CSV. All right, last important note with this method is that you can only load up to page 100 in Apollo. What that means is that because they should display 25 results per page, you can only get up to 2,500 at a time. So we've just now saved a list longer than 2,500. Crap, what are we gonna do? The solution is a bit boring, but it just does work, is that you're going to have to divide the list with the filters a bit further. So for us, the most reliable way that we do it is we divide the list. There's a lot of different ways you can do it, but for us, the way that we like to do it that works most reliably is that we subdivide the location a bit further. So we'll bring up like the list of the 50 states in the USA. And then in this case, because the list is 3,800 or however many, it's already close to 2,500. The simplest way is we'll just divide the states in half, load up half the states one way, load up half the other. And then that should result in the whole list being below 2,500 for both batches. Then we'll run Easy Scraper twice, download them all, put them in a spreadsheet, and we're off to the races. And that is how you scrape Apollo at a fraction of its usual cost. All right, that's it for this video. Be sure to subscribe if you want to learn more information about how to leverage AI and get clients with cold email outreach. And if you want our help setting up your cold email campaign, then hit me up on LinkedIn or visit our website. Links in the description below. Until next time. Why would you choose Apollo instead of using LinkedIn? Apollo has a lot more filters that really help you narrow down your target market even further. But I would warn you that if you can get away with using LinkedIn, that you probably should, because LinkedIn has